Hello again. I'm back. I was coming out here to... Maybe you can hear the noise. It's a waterfall down here. I was coming here to go down to that bottom of that fall, river fall, to tell you a story. I'm alone, and I don't know if you can see, but this is very... It's far way down, it's very steep, and I am alone. If I tremble and fall down here, I will never get back up, so I will not take any risks on that. I can try to zoom in. There is the waterfall. And far down here is, oh my god. It's very steep. This fall has a story. I will try to tell it. It's an old legend story about a beautiful virgin that lived on a big farm close to here. Her name was Josephine Grande. And she was known in the whole area to be the most beautiful virgin. And on the other side of the lake, there lived a shining knight, not shining, but a knight hero. He had heard of this beautiful virgin that lived here. She lived alone with her father. And he decided to come here and look for the virgin and ask for her hand in marriage. What this hero didn't know was that Josephine's father, he protected her with fear, terrorism, and terror. So he was very angry when the knight came and looked for his daughter. So one late night, this hero decided to kidnap the virgin. So he kidnapped her and carrying her on the shoulder, running down the hill from the farm and down through this waterfall. And the father of the virgin was chasing close behind them. So in sheer panic, he jumped over the fall on the top here. And in the moment he jumped, he trembled and he fell, and he managed to throw the virgin over the waterfall. So she landed on the other side, but the hero, he fell down in the fall and drowned in the water. In despair, the virgin, of course, she was very sad and start crying, and the legend say that her tears doubled the water level in the fall, so the father, he didn't dare to jump after. So she was finally set free from her father, and if she lived happily ever after, the story doesn't say anything about that, but she was happy to finally escape her father. So that's the story about this waterfall, and that was the reason I came here, actually. But I can really not risk climbing down there. I am not in that good shape. As I said, if I fall down here, I will never get back up. So I will not risk anything. There is a little clearance in the forest here, so I will try to send up the drone to film the waterfall, maybe capture some pictures of it. So maybe I will go down there to the bottom of the fall another time when I'm not alone. I don't know really if you can see it, but a video vlog on YouTube is not worth risking my life over. So I think I leave it with that. So I will send up the drone. Yes. Yeah, we can go back. I will show you something. They keep this legend alive here. The story I told you. This is actually a little exercise. It's an exercise too. Oh, look down here. I will be crazy if I go down there when I'm alone. I cannot do that. So I went past a viewpoint on the way down here. Here you can see. They are burning candles to keep the story alive in memory of the hero that freed the virgin from the terrorist father. There's something in the tree. I will look at that. Oh my god. I am scared of hides. Look down here. It's far down. What is this? Boxed something. I don't know what it is. But here is the top of the fall. I will be careful here too. Down there is the top of the fall, and this is the place he was jumping across. I think maybe it's nice to take some pictures here. Yes, I will try to take some nice pictures. Oh, I have to sit down. I was taking some pictures sitting on my knees and I got so dizzy. And the noise here is incredible. Oh. I need to be careful doing this. But it's nice to sit there. Look. If I had been in better shape, I would take a swim down there. But not today. So I think I'm about done here. You can go down to the big lake and look at the old lady that is on the lake there. We have an old steamboat trafficking the lake, so we'll go down there. I am not very confident about the history of the boat. I know that it's built in Motala, Sweden. They start building it in 1854 and it was finished in 1856. And in Motala in Sweden. How they managed to transport that boat from Sweden to Norway in 1856, I don't know anything about that. The boat is like 50.5 meters long, 5.5 meters wide, and the speed of the boat is like 14 knots. And it's the oldest steamboat in regular traffic in the world. The first trip it had August 2nd in 1956. So this summer it had two major breakdowns. So this summer it's been lying here most of the time because it's have some major issues with some engine. It's a steam engine. I can imagine that parts for this is not easy to find. I guess everything needs to be fabricated. So they said that this season is ruined. That's sad actually. It's a nice boat, it's a nice trip. And it goes to 7 different destinations on this lake. It's for tourists, and you can charter it for like company parties or something like that too, but in the summer it goes in regular traffic. One in 1937 and 1962, the boat actually sink. It has been on the bottom of this lake 2 times when it was in winter storage. First time it went down was in 1937, and the other was 1962, and it has been restored many times. So this is this is history. I know that the boat is, the name is Skibladner. That's an old, it's from the Viking age. It has something to do about Freya and Thor and Odin and yeah. I am not sure of it, so I will not come into that. But this boat you can Google. The name is Skibladner, and the second name of it is the White Swan of the Lake. So this is history. So I'm in Gjøvik. There are 3 cities around the lake. It's Lillehammer in the north, it's Gjøvik here in the middle on the west side, and you have Hamar further south on the east side. As I told you many times before, that this lake is like 100 kilometers long. And it's the same lake I have my boat to, so it's nice. Yeah. So we are on historic grounds with this boat, and yeah. I never been on this boat. Actually, there was some medium psychic lady. I don't know actually what you say in English. She is like, she can look into the future. She is dead now, but she, before she died, she said that she could see that this boat will go down on the lake with a lot of people on board. And I have been close to this boat out on the water with my own boat, and it looks very unstable actually. And it had some accidents, crashing into some piers and stuff like that. It's said to be very difficult to maneuver this boat, and I can imagine that. it's not easy to steer this. There are some people up by the restaurant here that looking at me. They think I'm crazy. Go talk to myself, probably. But I am doing better with that. I don't care so much. So, on the clouds, it's getting dark up in the hills. I don't know if it's going to rain or thunderstorm is coming. But I think this is it for now. We had the waterfalls that I could not go down to. But I got to fly some drone over there. And also with this boat. So I think this is enough for now. Until next time.